Just a big toast to you. Missionary, come on up and get the mission today. I'm saying that. Let's see you shake that. Yeah. I'm waiting for you. Sometimes you gotta praise your way through. Sometimes you gotta praise your way out of the situation. Yeah.
Happy birthday to all you October and November birthdays. Today, Fall Fun Fellowship is today after service at 12 until 2 at Thieves Farm. Try to arrive at 11:45 and meet at Greenhouse Number 7. The children will be sponsored and all adults will pay $10 if you wish to visit Pumpkin Land. Church check-in is today at 6 p.m. The missionaries are asking you to support the Helena B. Cobb Scholarship and Save Our Sons Scholarship by giving an extra donation today. I wanted to give you a little brief history on Helena B. Cobb, since this is our way of helping our children. Helena Brown Cobb was an educator, missionary worker, editor, writer, and feminist, at a time when African Americans were denied many basic human rights. Her vision was to create an educational oasis for Black youth, combining education with Christian leadership and living, thus making their lives better. A scholarship was begun in her honor to aid applicants on a yearly basis. Applicants must apply or reapply each year. Applicants must be active female or male members of the Christian Methodist Episcopal Church and a high school graduating senior planning to attend a college or university or currently enrolled in college or a university. Murchison Tabernacle has had a number of recipients that received this scholarship, and the St. Louis district had a student, Mia Ward, from Colvin Wright, that received the four-year Helena B. Cobb Higher Learning Scholarship. This scholarship will be presented at our next quadrennial assembly in Jacksonville, Florida, in June of 2023. Please, let's give what we can to support our young adults and future leaders of our CME Church. Your vote matters. Election day is Tuesday, November 8th. Beginning 10/25/22 until 11/7 at 5 p.m., all registered voters can vote in person at their local election office without giving a reason. This is the incredibly convenient option for voters that is no different than voting on election day. We are looking forward to the opportunity it provides to hopefully lessen the length of election day lines and help increase voter turnout across the state. If you need assistance, call the church office. Make sure you get a voter's guide and a voter's information card as you leave this morning. We are celebrating family and friends the entire month of November. Each of you have an invitation in your worship packet. If you are a member, share the invitation with who you would like to come worship with you. If you need more invitations, just let us know. That concludes the announcements. Have a great week. God bless you.
Good morning, church family.
Good morning.
When I think about what the Lord has done, when I think about where he brought me from, when I think about the many, many victories, I can't help myself. I've got to praise him. So come on and let's worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness.
All right.
Let us pray. Oh, Father, who is in heaven, thank you, Lord, for watching over us all night and waking us up this morning with the mind to come out and worship you one more time. Thank you, Lord, for protecting us, blessing us, and hearing our prayers. Forgive us, Lord, for anything we've done that's not pleasing to you, and help us, Lord, to love one another and do your will. Lord, I ask a special blessing that you please come to all the families who were impacted by the tragic shooting at Central High School on Monday. All these blessings I ask in your name, Jesus, for everything I thank you that you allow me to do. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
He ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God, Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
So y'all know I gotta say something, right? So I don't know what you did, Sister Ricky. To get me to join up here. Well, I just gotta say something. So when she came up here, you all were praising. But she wasn't worried about y'all praying. She just wanted to get through her thing. And she just immediately said, it's time for the affirmation. I mean, what y'all doing? Because I got to get to this amen. And I just got to, but I'm like, just let the Spirit flow here. Just let them praise a little bit. She's not, now I'm up here, and I'm getting ready to do what I have to do and sit down. So I just had to say that. Amen.
Yes, hold on. Hold on. Everything will be all right. In Psalm 4, he tells us, if you know my name, you will trust me. So I'm going to do what I'm supposed to do. Call me Lord.
Someone will pick it up. You have give a five. We don't even have to leave home to give our tithes.
God has made a way that all we got to do, y'all know y'all like to check, check, check. God has made a way for you to check, 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 and give your offering. The missionaries are asking you to give offering today for the healthy car, which Miss Snow already had announced that. For those who are online, you may give or give a five, like I said. That's right. Lord, we thank you for your faith to us, which allowed us to be back to you. Please bless us with what we have received and what we will receive. In your name, let us use it unwieldy. For your kingdom, in Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Hold on. Hold on. Amen.
You have chosen us to come and worship with this morning. Would any of you like to say anything before you sit down to let us know who you are and where you're visiting from? Corliss?
My name is Corliss White. I'm from Greenburg, but I'm not a visitor. I'm just worshiping at another place.
Marsha Lester Smith. I'm going to tell you a little bit about Marsha, even though most of you know her. She's not a stranger to any of us here that are members, and she's not a stranger to the visitors. Marsha Lester Smith was born to the late Leo and Odessa Smith Lester in Chicago, Illinois. She's the seventh of 11 children and was educated in the Cook County school system. She became a member of Jameson Memorial CME Church in 1983 and is currently a member of Rebirth CME Church under the pastoral leadership of Reverend Dr. Frederick Hicks. She is also active in her local church as a steward, member of the health ministry, and other organizations. Marsha is also the assistant secretary, recording secretary of the St. Louis District Missionary Society. She has been active in the Missionary Society since 1996 and chaired the Dr. Elnora B. Ham Health Initiative for several years in the past at the region level. She is currently the Phyllis H. Bedford Secretary for the Southeast Missouri, Illinois, and Wisconsin region. Marsha has received numerous awards with the community and Missionary Society. She is currently on the Phyllis H. Bedford Committee and the Pauline B. Grant Status of Women Committee at the Women's Missionary Council level and Rebirth CME Church, Women's Missionary Society's Vice President. Marsha has been a registered nurse for over 46 years. Yes, give her a hand, yes. She's one of those that's been on the front line. And a family nurse practitioner for over 11 years. She has worked, that's okay, come on with me, come on with me. That's right, she deserves it. Yes. She currently works at Passport Health, St. Louis, and previously at St. Louis County Public Health System at the COVID Response Unit, dealing with COVID testing and outcome of the test herself. She is also a COVID vaccinator. Her community affiliations include being a member of the American Nurses Association, NAACP, The Latest Hope, to name a few. She is a member of the Rome Chapter, Chi Edify Sorority Incorporated, and some of her sorority sisters are here today. We are excited to have Sister Marsha Luster Smith today as our Missionary Sunday speaker. After the music selection, the next voice you will hear will be Sister Reba Snow, then Sister Marsha Luster Smith. Thank you. Give Sister Marsha a hand. Bring her on with you. Welcome. Let her know you appreciate her being here.
Coming from Isaiah 43, 16 through 21. I'll say it one more time. Isaiah 43, 16th chapter through the 21st. I'm sorry, chapter 43, 16 through 21 verses. If you found it, you can read along with me. I'm reading from the New King James Version. Thus says the Lord, who makes a way in the sea and a path through the mighty waters, who brings forth the chariot and horse, the army and the power. They shall lie down together. They shall not rise. They are extinguished. They are quenched like a wick. Do not remember the former things, nor consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? I will even make the road in the wilderness. The beasts of the field will honor me, the jackals and the ostriches, because I give waters in the wilderness, and rivers in the desert, to give drink to my people, my chosen, though this people I have formed for myself. They shall declare my praise. I've read to you Isaiah 43:16-21. May the Lord add a blessing to the hearers, readers, and doers of his holy word.
Amen.
Amen. Give my
To you, I give all of my soul, I give myself, so I give myself, thank you. I give myself, I give myself, my all. To you, I give all of my soul, I give myself, so I give myself, thank you.
This is something new. So I ask for your prayers.
I ask for your support as I move forward with the word from God.
Okay.
The thing for today is God has given us the opportunity for a new thing in this new year. For we are in a new conference year, starting in after July 2022, and it's going all the way through to June of next year, 2023, or July, really, of next year, 2023, with a new opportunity. Celebrating a new year is a time to express our gratitude to God for enabling us to see another year in this life. Most of us know of relatives, friends, classmates, and neighbors, church members who passed during the pandemic that started in 2020 to now in 2022. A new year allows us an opportunity to reflect back on last year and acknowledge that we may have had some challenges and some good times. Celebrating the fact that we are still here. Thank God. We want to thank him again for celebrating the new year that gives us one more time to set personal goals for better health, better relationships with family and friends. This is also a time to thank God for a reasonable portion of our health and strength, and for family, church members, and friends. Celebrating a new year is a time to reflect on our Christian life. This is a good time to give thanks to God for our faith, our church, our fellow church members who are a part of our extended family. Our pastor, presiding elder, bishop, and the entire CME church. But most of all, it's a time to thank God for sending us his son. Jesus Christ. This year we have another opportunity to do something to make us better Christians. We have another opportunity to be better church members. And we have another opportunity to share the good news of Jesus Christ with those who may not know him. The Women's Missionary Council of the CME Church and missionaries in attendance during the quadrennial in 2019 chose a theme for the next 4 years. And that theme is still being utilized today. Embracing a new era of invitation for greater service. We'll be meeting next year in June 2023 to discuss at the quadrennial on decide on our next thing. But I looked in the program today and I saw the thing that was developed in June of this year by the General Conference. Be bold, face now, embrace next, see new. That's a new thing that we are focusing on in this new year and the years to come. Our past editor, Julian Waddell Pittman, gave us several ideas or ways we can put into action anything that we have. First, we want to read our Bible daily, pray, meditate, and praise God daily, give thanks to God daily, attend Sunday school. We need Sunday school because it starts our day. Attend Bible study. Share God's work with others. Tell others of God's goodness to you. Invite others to worship with you at your church. Practice truly listening to others. Laugh daily because they say laughter is good for the soul. Practice healthier eating habits. Build more exercise into your daily routine. And we all can do that on a daily basis. Get a proper amount of rest more consistently. Smile and show the love of Christ to all whom you encounter every day. Our immediate International Women's Missionary Council President, Dr. Princess Dee, expressed her thoughts about a new year and a new beginning in a poem that was written by Marilyn Hughes.
Excuse me. With each new year, promises are made and promises are broken. Resolutions are made and forgotten by the middle of the year. The world is in a desperate situation. Let's do all we can to change things, because you can change, because with God, anything is possible. Let's start this year with a new beginning and with God. Let's start with a fresh start, revitalizing everyone and everything around us. Take a look at the things you did last year and strive to improve this year. Be kinder and more compassionate to others. Pray for your neighbors, your lawmakers. We got an election coming up, right? Let's pray for those lawmakers and those that are moving on up. We look for them to guide and direct us in this country. And those that despitefully use you, vow to read your Bible more this year. Pray, sing, and praise God every day. Keep your mind on heavenly things. Love your family, friends, neighbors, and even your enemies. Seek pleasant things and be a peacemaker, not a peace breaker. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. And Juliet also said, love, Lord, in my life, work in me to plan with wisdom, to guide with vision, to lead with humility, to listen with understanding, to work with excellence, and to succeed in a way that honors you. I thank God for this new conference year, 2022-2023, and I'm looking forward to all of the opportunities and new things that God would afford me and direct me on. Because as we said before, with God, all things are possible. Now, what about you, missionaries, church members, friends of Murchison Tabernacle Christian Methodist Episcopal Church? I pray you have a blessed new conference year with a new thing and a new opportunity. So as I close, I want to end with a song that Mother Edna Foxworth, as you know, she's one of our past presidents of the St. Louis District Missionary Society. Sister B. Payne is one of our past presidents of the St. Louis District Missionary Society, wanted me to use this song for my closing. I ask everyone to join in with me as I sing one verse. Please stand. Thank you, those who can. And the name of the song is really simple. This is the day that the Lord has made. We're going to rejoice and be glad in it. Come on with it. Sister Marsha was so excited she got here. What time was Sister Nita? 8:45. She got here at 8:45. She said, at least I had that behind me. I'm just going to get there. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you for allowing the Lord to use you and just speak to our hearts to let us know that God has given us this great opportunity to serve him in this new conference year, and that the Lord has spoken that he will do a new thing in us, a new thing in others, and it's an honor and a privilege. It's a blessing to be able to share in the work of the Lord, and so we give God all the glory and all the praise, and we celebrate the fact that God would choose us to serve him in whatever capacity it is, that God would choose us and would give us the opportunity. I used to say some years ago that I have to preach. Like if I was invited somewhere, I say I have to, and now I say I get to. I get to do it for the Lord. It's not a burden. It's not something I'm dreading to do, but I get to do it. And so we ought to be excited to get to do whatever God is calling us to do. Be excited when God calls your name. Be excited when God wants you to serve in whatever capacity. Be excited when God wants you to lend a helping hand. Be excited when God wants you to show up and have the ministry of presence. So we are grateful that God uses us for his glory. We want to extend the invitation of Christian discipleship, because all that we say and do when we come to God's house leads to the moment of decision. Everything that's said as we praise God in song, as we read scriptures, as we speak on his behalf, all of that is to lead us to a moment of decision. But Joshua said, I don't know about you, but me and my house, we will serve the Lord. So it becomes our responsibility at this point to choose ye this day whom you will serve. You can't serve two guys. You'll love one and hate the other. And God doesn't like any lukewarm people. Be hot or cold. Make a decision. If you want to serve this God who was willing to send his son to die for you. I'm going to ask that everyone would please stand at this time. I'm glad that I can trust that God will speak to our music ministry, because when they played I Give Myself Away, I just thought of how fitting it was for all of us, but especially for our speaker. And so we just thank the Lord that God always has the right thing to say through music or words to speak to our hearts. And now God is speaking to your heart. And perhaps he is speaking that you need to come to me and be saved. He's already proven that you were to die for. I love you so much, I died for you. And then if the Lord is speaking to your heart and saying, give yourself back to me again, rededicate your life to me, then he's speaking to you now. If you don't have a church home, God is speaking that he wants you to come down this aisle, then you need to obey his voice. And if you're standing in need of prayer, God is saying, I want to pray for you. I want to lift you up. I want to speak to your heart because of what you're carrying and what you're going through. All of those invitations are for you. The first one was the most important, salvation. Do you know Jesus today? Do you know him in the pardoning of your sin? Do you know this love that's so great, that's indescribable and immeasurable? And nothing can change God's love for you, no matter how bad we mess up, no matter how far astray we go, nothing can separate us from the love of God. Nothing will keep God from loving us. Absolutely nothing. And you want to draw closer. We began service, and I'm chasing after you. You want to chase after, get a little closer to the Lord. You can rededicate your life to him. If you stand in need of salvation, rededication, membership, or prayer, remain standing. All others may be seated. If any of those invitations are speaking to your heart, remain standing.
Hallelujah. Bless you, bless you. I see you, I see you. Let's allow this song to minister and they will address your needs. Just a little bit more rocking. Anybody need a place to stay? If you're blessed in this season, don't move and don't be moved. Don't do it. If you're blessed in this season, don't move without being moved. Perhaps you need healing. Say, don't do it without me, Lord. Perhaps you need deliverance. Don't do it without me, Lord. You want to be included in the blessing of God and the healing of God, the salvation of God. Don't do it without me, Lord. You need to be delivered. Lord, don't do it without me. You need God's peace. Don't do it without me, Lord. You need the joy of the Lord, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. Don't do it without me. There's anyone that's worshiping with us virtually, if you have a need, please address it in the chat. Post on Facebook so that we can acknowledge what your needs are this morning. All right, take things giving. Okay. First of all, is anyone standing for salvation? Anybody need to accept Jesus in your heart? I see you, my brother. The word of God, I'm going to ask you to just come down here for a moment. Just step down and fall on. Oh, we bless God. We bless God today. We bless God today. Come on up here, brother. Come on up here. I want to say to you that God is saving in this business. He's in the saving business and the saving season. And the word of God declares that you believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that God raised Jesus from the dead, then you shall be saved. Not might be. You don't have to do anything else. You don't have to do no extra stuff. It says what it says. Then you shall be saved. Do you believe that Jesus died for you? Do you believe that God raised Jesus from the dead? Do you believe that on the third day he rose with all power in his hand? Do you believe that God loves you in spite of you, that nothing you can do to keep God from loving you? Then you are saved in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Saved in the mighty name of Jesus. You are God. You belong to God, and God is yours. Hallelujah. God had already claimed you. He chose you before you chose him. He already loved you before you had sense enough to love a God that was sent his son to die for you. He already loved you in spite of all your weaknesses and your faults, your mess ups, trip ups. He already loved you. So if God loves us and knows everything about us and still loves us, don't let the devil tell you that you are not loved by God. So God knows everything we've done, what we're doing right now, and what we will do. And God say, I love you the same. He loves you with everlasting love. And we give God glory. We give God glory. Bless you. Showing your son come and stand with his daddy. Amen. Stand with your daddy. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The symbolism here is powerful. The symbolism here is powerful. And I want you to treasure this moment. I want you to have this image in your spirit of you coming to God and your son coming to you to God. So when things get a little shaky and you start doubting God's love, remember holding your son right now. And remember that God sent his son to die for you. Hallelujah. And we give God the word. We'll get all your information. Give us your full name. I can't repeat it like you. You could say it in the mic.
My name is John Moroma.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And now I have another question for you. You have accepted Jesus as Lord of your life, and it becomes my responsibility to help you in this process. So I'm going to ask if you have membership at another church. Is the Lord speaking to you to join Murchison? Well, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We give God glory and we give God praise. Because as you accept Jesus, know that the enemy not going to like you. And so you need a family to support you, to take a village, right? You need a village that will keep you lifted high in prayer. And then you all do know that when a man comes to God, hallelujah, because the enemy is after our men and after our boys. And so you can expect an attack from the enemy because the scripture tells us that the enemy comes to kill, steal, and destroy. But you are covered in the name of Jesus. Lifting you up. That's right. Love on a mother. That's right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. He's worthy. Hallelujah. Love on him. Anybody here for rededication today? Oh, we bless God today. We bless God today. God used you, my friend. God used you. Anybody here for membership? Oh, bless the name of the Lord, Lord Jesus Christ, and in the name of Jesus, we already claimed you, my sister. We claim you in the mighty name of Jesus. To God be the glory for all he has done. I won't ask you to come down, but I just bless God for you. I bless God for you. And your husband's checked in the office to see if he was coming up in the pulpit. I say, sit with your wife, okay? And it's a beautiful sight for you all to be sitting there and worshiping together. So we give God praise for you. We already love you. Hallelujah. We already know you. And we thank God for putting it on your heart to come and make Murchison your place of membership. We thank God for you. And we already got your information. I got your address. I know your name. We already got you. Just need to know your birthday. Amen. We already got you. We receive you right now, today, in the name of Jesus. God bless you. God bless you. The Lord has blessed us with two members today. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. We give God glory. We give God praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. When God speaks, I'm not going to tell anybody to go anywhere and join a church, but when God speaks, you need to answer to what the Lord says. When God speaks, he has you right where he wants you to be. And now for those who are standing, I'm assuming you're standing with prayer. Bless it. Bless it. Bless you. Yes, Ms. Eloise. Give her the mic. Give her this mic. 1 second, Miss Eloise. Because I want to hear what you're saying. I want everybody else to hear. I can pretty much figure it out, but I want everybody else to hear what you're saying. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
I just want to say, I am not here today to ask God for anything. Rather, I am here to praise Him.
Mother had a, Miss Eloise had a birthday a couple days ago, and then she coming. What she said?
Yesterday.
And she said, I'm not here to ask God for anything. How many of y'all be asking God for something when you have a birthday? She said, I didn't come to ask God for anything, but to thank God. Because God has been good. Amen. Amen. Happy birthday, happy birthday.
She can't tell him her age. Tell him how old I am.
How old are you? I want to say it right. 95 years old.
Hallelujah.
To God be the glory. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. He promised 70, but he went above and beyond the blessing. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Amen. God bless you. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Amen. Sister Thea. Yes. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you. We praise you and we honor you for this wonderful day that you have made. And we celebrate your blessings. We celebrate salvation today. And our brother came and gave his heart to you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that he realized he needed a Savior. We thank you, Lord God, that you had already chosen him and loved him, but yet he was willing to come out of his comfort zone in the pews and come and receive you into his heart. We thank you, Lord God. We pray your comfort over him, oh God, that you would keep him. Reassure him that he is yours and that you love him and that thing he can do about it. And Lord, there are others who are standing. We celebrate Miss Eloise. You blessed her, oh God, with 95 years of life. And she's not grown weary in well-doing. And whenever she can, she makes her way to your house, oh God. And we thank you for her example. We thank you for her legacy. We thank you for her love. We thank you, Lord God, that she keeps on encouraging us along the way, even by her presence. We thank you for her, oh God. We pray healing and we pray strength in her body, that she will continue to do what you called her to do. And now others are standing, oh God, and they have some needs. And although I don't know what they need, you know. Because of your sovereignty, oh God, you know everything about everything. And so you know how to minister to each one, oh God, and you're not confused about who needs what. And so we thank you right now for meeting their personal needs, where you sit high, but you look low. You're a big God, and yet you are up close and personal, God. So we thank you that no matter how small it is, whatever we're concerned about, you're concerned about as well. You told us to cast our cares on you, for you care for us, so we give it to you right now, oh God. Every need in the room, every need that's on Zoom, every need that's on Facebook, we give it to you right now, oh God. We give it to you. Give us the strength not to take it back. We give it to you right now, oh God, because we know that you are prayer answer, God. We trust you. Yeah. Even with the stuff we don't want to say out loud, we trust you with it, oh God. And know that you are able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask, think, or imagine. So we bless your name. We give you every care. We give you every concern. We give you every situation. We give you every circumstance. And we thank you in advance. We thank you right now. It might not change by the time we get home, but we know it's in your hands. It's going to be all right. It might not feel like my body is healed, but because you said I am Jehovah Rapha, I'm the God who heals, we're going to claim healing right now. I still might be a little troubled, but you are the God of comfort, so I claim the comfort right now. I might be in the midst of a storm, but God, we claim your peace that surpasses all understanding right now.
that you would speak to the storms of our life and they have to cease, Lord God. We're speaking right now, but we walk by faith and not by sight. Regardless of what it looks like, we're still going to give you praise. No matter what it feels like, we're still going to say thank you, Jesus. No matter how long it goes on, we say thank God it is done in the name of Jesus. And I want to continue to bless our speaker that came out of her comfort zone, oh God. When she's talking about missionary work and talking about the health ministry, oh God, she can talk endlessly, but Lord, you gave her a word, a simple word just to share with us today, and she was willing to do it for you. So we thank you, Lord God, that you did a new thing in her, even today. We give you praise. We thank you for every visitor that came, some to support her and some not knowing who would stand at the sacred desk. But Lord, we thank you for each and every one. Continue to bless. Continue to reveal yourself. Continue to remind us that you are God all by yourself and you don't need our help. Continue to let us know, God, that you are our shepherd and we shall not want. We stand in the gap for those who are ill. One sister is standing in the gap for another sister. Theta, who's going through herself, is standing for another sister going through. We thank you right now for Phyllis's healing in the name of Jesus. We claim her healing, oh God, right now, in the mighty name of Jesus. And not only for hers, but for others with a diagnosis. And no matter what that diagnosis is, it's not bigger than you. We claim it right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray and we give you thanks. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. Why y'all stop claiming? I was trying to feel it, and I couldn't feel it, but I was praying, so I want to hear some more of that. That's what I call. Anybody call him Jesus? That's what I call him. I have one last thing I'd like to do before the benediction. Sister Betty, if you would kind of make your way up here. Last week we did not have a poster for you, but I have one for you today. So I would like for you to guess, ma'am, you, Betty, Bars.
Who, me?
Yes, you. Amen. Gonna come down, but I saw her reaching for the reel. She said, I'm coming up.
All right. Go ahead, girl.
All right. Bless you. Amen. Now she's doing that missionary thing today. Y'all see her?
All right. So we give God praise for you for being a breast cancer survivor. And we wanted to make sure we gave this to you.
Sharing in worship, and we give God glory for you. We celebrate your victory. Your victory is our victory. Amen. Amen.
They got you. You don't refuse help.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Madam President and Reverend Saunders. Thank you so much. Before the benediction, know that we are going to these warm, rain or shine. I don't know what it's doing outside, but I hope you all dress for it. Amen. Because we are going in the name of Jesus. So we pray God's blessing on our fun time together. We have about 20 children going, about 20 adults going, and we're going to have some nachos, and they're going to go to Pumpkin Land, and they're going to just have a good time. If you're going with us, it's right on Hanley. We have some flyers in the event that you need that information. We will give it to you. I want to remind you, as you exit, you will be able to share your offering as well as receive a voter's guide and voter information. We want everybody to have the information so that you can be an informed voter. We don't want you going to the poll any, many, many more. I voted for a woman, now I vote for a man. Don't play. It's serious. And so we have the voters guides, and you can certainly request a ballot
They have a little scan on the voter ID cards now. I noticed that in the mail that you can just scan that and get the ballot so you'll know what's on there so that you can be prepared when you get there. It's not just good to say you voted when you don't know what you're voting for. Amen? So we want to make sure that you are informed. Amen. Just so you know, those that are visiting with us, we do exit from the rear to the front. We don't fellowship inside. We try to keep everybody safe by moving quickly and exiting the building. So be mindful of that. If you need assistance and it's time for your row to exit, just stay there. It takes you a little longer. Don't feel rushed. Just sit there until you're able to get up and go. You will actually exit facing the windows and go up the side aisles to exit the building. Amen. After the benediction, I'm going to ask those that are in the pulpit to remain for a few moments for a picture. Let us receive the benediction at this time. Lord, we thank you for how you continue to bless us over and over again. Not because we've been so good, not because we deserve it, but because you are good. Because you love us, we are grateful. Now we pray a blessing as we depart this place of worship, O God. And we thank you that you have been with us, that we have felt your presence. And we pray that our praise was acceptable in your sight. Now unto him who was able to keep us from falling and present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forevermore. Let the people of God say amen. 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 Go on and throw a virtual hug or a kiss across the other side of the sanctuary. Because you ain't gonna get it in here. Just go on and throw a, give them a hug. Give them a hug. Show them some love right where you are. Amen. Those who have worshiped with us virtually, thank you so much for joining us. Facebook and Zoom. We thank God for your presence. We thank you for worshiping with us, and we pray that you are blessed today. Amen. Have a wonderful week. To God be the glory. Amen. Amen. Give us a little music as we exit.